Hi, my name is Witten, and welcome back to my next episode on TrevoCraft. First of all, I want to thank all my viewers and subscribers for supporting my channel, and I have made a monument in that honor. So I reached more than 100 subscribers at this moment, so I thought, why not make something just for that. So I made here an obelisk, and it is centered on a compass, so north, south, west and east. It's a nice addition to the map, I think. And yeah, the top is lit up. It is not yet finished, but all this clearing of the land, making flat and building this tower took me about 12 hours. But I still have got some grass to clear and put in gravel and so on. Now, you may have noticed that the amount of videos for TrevoCraft has lowered drastically. And that is mainly because at this moment we are somewhat stuck until we find all the goodies, all the ore that we need to advance. So at this moment we are still missing silver, and silver is needed to make black bronze, and from there on we can go to the other kinds of steel, black steel, red steel and blue steel. Of course, I haven't been sitting still all this time, so I built the monument, finished this road you'll hear, cleared up the center here. At first I wanted to make this is too flat. So I'm not sure. First of all, I wanted to put these fruit trees back at this spot, not at this place. But I think that they will be too wide because they come with the leaves still here and they're not very high, so they will block the path. So I will think about it and maybe put some flower pots, flower beds or something in here, I don't know. But in this episode, first of all, let's see, do we have something? No, we do not. So, anyway, in this episode I will show you how to make steel. Steel is the next evolution from the normal wrought iron, this anvil. And as you can see, Mark has already made a blast furnace, and he combined this with a forge, so this is very handy, everything in one place, very compact, perfect. He already made a steel anvil. There's still some pig iron left in here, it seems, but the mold is empty. Maybe it has cooled down too much, but okay. I think that he used almost 9 stacks of charcoal for this, to make this and his armor. So it is quite expensive, takes a lot of time to do. But anyway, I will show you how to make steel. So, first of all, you need to make this blast furnace. This blast furnace can go up to 6 high, so count on this block 6 high. Underneath you have to put a crucible, put a bellows behind both, and this block itself, blast furnace, is made from a crucible and 8 double sheets of wrought iron around it. So it is quite a lot of time that you need for this and a lot of work. So for the next step that we want to make, we also need a third blast crucible. So I will show you how to make those. First of all, you need some graphite, 20 pieces, and some kaolinite. You also need 5 normal clay, and then you have to grind this kaolinite and graphite into powder. For this you will need a kern. This handstone may die in this process. Come on. There we go. Each time that I hit this, my frame rate drops till 18 frames. So I have to do this 40 times. So I will do this and I will bring you back. And it broke, so let's make a new one. I don't have the material in here. So let us grab, where do we have marble? Yeah. Three stone. This way. Stick at one end and we have got an end stone. So I will continue with this. Wow, that was very exciting. So now we have to make fire clay. We do this in a workbench. 5 clay in the center. Put the graphite around and the kaolinite as well. Wrong order, I think. There we go. So the kaolinite in the corner. And we got 5 fire clay. Now we don't have to bake this, so we just take this in our hand, right click and make a bucket. There we go, we got our crucible completely made, no baking, just napping it out of the clay. So now we need to find a place for this. I was thinking of putting it right here, but then I will have to move these anvils. and I'm not sure. I think that will be still possible to hit these bellows. Okay, so let's take out everything. Shift click doesn't work. Great. Put these in a chest for now. Okay. We also need some dolomite bricks for this. Now, if you're thinking that steel is a lot better than these bronze tools, then you will be disappointed. It is not, sadly. You will see a difference in durability, but not in the speed that you can mine these things. Can I put these? No. Well, let's put these for now here. I will sort those out later. So put down a block of coal, charcoal. Eight, and light it up. Light it up, light it up. And no, of course not. Come on, thank you. So we need a forge, and we will just put the crucible on top. Do I need to shift it? Yeah. There we go. So this is completely ready to make our alloys, and the alloys will be black bronze, black steel, blue steel, and red steel. Later on I will finish this chimney, but for now this will prevent anything from dropping in on us. Oh yeah, we also need a bellows, so let's make that quickly. Wrong chest. Got one dirt. No, that is full. There we go. So for a bellows we need 3 leather and 6 planks. Let's take this. Planks at top, planks at the bottom, and leather in the middle. There we go. Right, these things. Placed in the wrong direction. Sorry, Mark. I will fix it. There we go. Cool. Okay, like I said, this one needs a crucible and 8 double sheets around it. I won't do that again, of course. I will just show you how to make, how to use this. So, how do we use this? We make. Blah blah blah. We take. Wow, is it everything that we have got? Okay, it looks like we will need to do some more digging. So we need a stack of charcoal, a stack of ore, and the same amount of flux. We go to the top of our chimney. Throw in our magnetite, in this case, our flux, and our charcoal. Now we take our lighter and light this thing from the front. Hello? Got our charcoal back. Why? Why? Alright. It seems that even though we are at patch 21, you first have to throw in the charcoal, then the iron ore, and the flux. And then it simply lights up. Normally, according to the wiki, you should right click it with a fire starter to light it up, but it does not. So, don't know what's up with that. But anyway, so this is lit up. It is in the middle. You can leave it like this and it will finish. No problem. It will take about half an hour, I think. So let's make a quick time-lapse, maybe. Put some nice music on and see how long it takes me by hitting the bellows at the back. Be right back. There we go. After 2 minutes, almost everything has passed through. And done. So 2 minutes, holding right click on the bellows will do it. And then you will end up with this tiny bit of big iron in this very big crucible. So of course then you put inside your empty molds, ceramic molds. I should clean out my inventory a little bit. This is insane. charcoal. So it seems it used 21 charcoal for 16 magnetite and 16 flux. So let's fill these up. Of course, I removed the anvils. Let's put the anvils down again. Should I stack them again? Yeah, why not? There we go. So that gave me 4 and a little bit of ingots. So yeah, that's it. Put the hammers back inside these things. Brilliant white liquid. Is there still some water inside? Apparently not. Let's go grab a bucket. I used all buckets over here. Because I was making mortar for the dolomite bricks over there. Let's throw a bucket of water inside. Oh, and it is cooled down already. So no need for it. So that's not right. Take it out. Put it in the slot and work it. It is always the same recipe for ingot, so let us just shrink it down. Then we got high carbon steel. Put it back inside and work it again. And there we go, a steel ingot. Now Mark made a complete set. Is it a complete set of armor out of this? It took him more than 1 hour. I think it was 2 hours to do it. I won't do that because, well, this armor gives enough protection, really. If you get swarmed by a mob of zombies, then it can get hairy, but usually you can get out of it without dying. So let's make a pickaxe from this single ingot, and we need to have a punch at last, a bend not last, and a draw not last. In the previous version it was more easily to understand what these things do, but draw brings it that way, bend takes that way, and punch also. So normally if you take it too far, I think. Draw, bend, no. We will need to bring it further back. So, draw, bend, and there we go. Almost Perfect pickaxe. So let's put that on a stick. And there we go. A steel pickaxe. As you can see, the damage is a lot higher, but you won't get much speed out of this. I can demonstrate this by destroying Mark's house a little bit. So not a lot of difference, only the durability is a lot higher, and you will notice that fairly well. So that will be it for this episode. I hope that you enjoyed my derping around a little bit with the blast furnace. Normally, according to the wiki and the change notes, we should light it like the bloomery from the front, but for some reason it does not work that way. So I will end the video here. So if you liked the video, please leave a like, subscribe for more videos if you haven't subscribed yet. Tell your friends about me if you've got friends that also watch YouTubers. And I will see you next time. Bye bye.